So fiqh means to understand the Qur'an and Sunnah, understand the verses of the Qur'an, understand the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When somebody is a faqih, then he is a jurist, he is a person who receives the hadith and then does not sit down and start relating. A muhaddith, what does he do? He sits with the hadith, he relates it further along. He'll have students in front of him, he'll teach, he'll say, look, these are the exact words of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What they mean? Allahu a'lam, I don't know, it's up to you. Whereas a faqih, a jurist, he will not sit there teaching hundreds and thousands of students the exact word, because that's an easy job actually in relation to the actual fiqh. He will sit with his students and extract the rules, derive rules out from the ahadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's what you call fiqh, and that's going deep. And that's why the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's fadila, there's virtues for both. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave some people the job of riwayatul hadith. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, the great Sahabi, he was called Mukthir min al-Hadith. He had many hadiths, 5,000, I think 754, 84, something, over 5,000 hadiths. But he wasn't sitting there extracting rules. And if you see on the other hand, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, they related less hadith from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That does not mean that they never received the hadith. The difference between a muhaddith and a faqih is a muhaddith receives the hadith and passes them on further along. He will write a book. He will write a book, Sahih al-Bukhari. He will write a book, Sahih Muslim, Sunan al-Tirmidhi, Sunan ibn Majah, Sunan al-Nasai. A faqih will not sit there. The faqih will also receive thousands and thousands of hadiths, just like the muhaddith. But the muhaddith's job is to teach the hadith, just pass it further along. Whereas a faqih will not do that. He'll sit down with the students and extract rules. So within the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, there were both jobs. Two types of companions. Some companions were dedicated. Actually, majority of the companions, they were mukthirun min al-hadith. They were excessively reporting, narrating, transmitting the actual words of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On the other hand, we had the fuqaha min al-sahaba, the Jewish sahaba, the muftiyan min al-sahaba, whose job description was to sit, extract, derive rules, istikhraj al-ma'ani, istinbat al-ma'ani. And also there was some other job description. Some sahaba radiallahu anhum, they were made the commanders of, you know, armies, like Khalid ibn al-Walid. Abu Huraira was a muhaddith, narrator of the hadith. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was a faqih. Mu'adh ibn Jabal was a faqih. Zayd ibn Thabit was a faqih. And Khalid ibn al-Walid was a commander. And likewise, we see the same pattern within the tabi'un, the followers of the sahaba, radiallahu anhum. Some tabi'un, they were the narrators of hadith. Some of them, they were the fuqaha and the muftiyan. And that's why when we look in these books of hadith, some people ask, why don't we find the names of Abu Hanifa? The name of Imam Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu, for example, in the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari, in the narrators of hadith, in the Sahih of Imam Muslim, and the Sunan of Imam al-Tirmidhi, and elsewhere, you don't find it. It's true, you're not going to find it. Because that was not his job. You would find the names of people like in the Sunan of Imam al-Tirmidhi, someone like, he says, Haddathana Musaddad bin Musarhad, Haddathana Qutayba bin Sa'id. You'll find people like Ahmed bin Ishqabs. These are the students or the grand students of Abu Hanifa. You'll find their names because their job was something else. You won't find the lawyers' name in the books of the doctors. It doesn't mean that they don't know some of the things. So the difference between a faqih and a muhaddith was that the faqih received thousands of hadiths. The muhaddith, he received thousands of hadiths as well. The muhaddith was sitting there and teaching the hadiths. The faqih wasn't teaching it, and that's why his name wouldn't be there. Exactly the same example we find in the sahaba radiallahu anhum as well. The sahaba radiallahu anhum, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhum, over 5,000 hadiths. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, a few hundred hadiths. That doesn't mean Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu knew about the Sunnah more than Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Far from it. Abu Bakr was the first Khalifa, but his job was something else. He was busy with the Khilafah and looking after the affairs of the Muslims in light of what he understood from the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And that's why in the earlier times, the ulama, they actually showed to us, or they explained to us, the difference between a faqih and a muhaddith. They said, al-fuqaha'u al-atibba' wal-muhaddithun al-sayadila. The jurists, they're the doctors. And the muhaddithun are pharmacists. You know the difference between a pharmacist and a doctor? A pharmacist keeps, stores medicines in his chemist. The doctor doesn't have any medicines. Does that mean the doctor does not know anything about the medicine? The doctor knows more about the medicine than the pharmacist. The pharmacist does not prescribe, well, you're not supposed to, in this day and age some pharmacists do, you know, they become doctors. I don't know if that's legally okay or not, but they're not supposed to, maybe in some small, you know, things here and there. But generally the pharmacist, his job is to store. You go to the pharmacy and you see hundreds and thousands of medicines. Likewise, you go to a muhaddith, you'll find hundreds and thousands of what? Hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You go into the surgery, there's no medicines, maybe one or two emergency ones. You go to the faqih, do you have them by you? No. Do you know about the hadith? Of course. More than the pharmacist. And this is exactly the difference between a faqih and a muhaddith. And this is why there's a story where Imam al-A'mash, who was a great Imam, once met Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah wa radi anhu. Imam al-A'mash was sitting, Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu was sitting with him. A person came and ja'a rajulun yas'aluhu an shay'in. A man came to ask a question. So Imam al-A'mash, who was a kind of teacher of Imam Abu Hanifa, he said, what do you say about this particular issue? ماذا تقول في كذا? What's your opinion about this person's problem? So Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah wa radi anhu, he said, such and such. He gave the answer. So Imam A'mash looked at him and he said, مِنْ أَيْنَ لَكَ هَذَا? Where did you get this from? Where's your dalil? You know, like, where's your dalil, brother, akhi? Where did you get this from? So Imam A'mash, Imam Abu Hanifa looked at him, and looked at Imam A'mash, he said, he pointed at him and he said, أَنْتَ حَدَّثْتَنَا عَنْ أَبِي صَالِحٍ عَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ كَذَا. You're the one who narrated to me from Abu Salih, from Abu Hurairah رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said this. وَأَنْتَ حَدَّثْتَنَا عَنْ أَبِي وَائِلٍ عَنْ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ بْنِ مَسْعُودٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ كَذَا. You're the one who reported to me and narrated to me from who? From Abu Wa'il, from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said this. وَأَنْتَ حَدَّثْتَنَا عَنْ أَبِي مِجْلَزٍ عَنْ حُذَيْفَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ كَذَا. Another دليل, you're the one who related to me from Abu Mijlaz, from حُذَيْفَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said this. وَأَنْتَ حَدَّثْتَنَا عَنْ يَزِيدَ الرَّقَاشِ عَنْ أَنَسٍ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ كَذَا. You're the one who reported to me from يزيد الرَّقَاشِ, from Anas ibn Malik, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said this. You know, Imam was flabbergasted. He looked at him and said, okay, hasbuk, it's okay enough. And then he said, ما حدثتك في مئة يوم حدثتني به في ساعة واحدة. What I transmitted to you in over 100 days, you're telling me back all of it in one go. And then he said, يا معشر الفقهاء, O group of فقهاء, jurists, أنتم الأطباء, you are the doctors, ونحن الصيادلة, and we are the pharmacists. And then he said, وأنت يا أيها الرجل, أخذت بكلا الطرفين, and you, O man, Abu Hanifa, you've taken both sides. You're actually even a doctor as well as a pharmacist. This is Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu. He was extracting rules, the same hadiths from which Imam al-A'mash was not able to derive the fiqh out. Imam Abu Hanifa was there taking up the fiqh out. And this is, it's a science, it's intelligence, it's a unique talent that Allah only blesses some people with.